Hi everyone, in this video we will see necessity of a starter for induction motor and star delta starter. So if you connect induction motor without using starter, so what will happen? So it draws about 5 to 7 times the full load current and it is produces the 1.5 to 2.5 times the full load torque. So once if it is induction motor draws the more amount of current and it produces the more amount of torque, so due to induction motor stator winding will damage, that is induction motor will spoil. So to avoid that one, here we are using the starter for induction motor. So here we have star delta starter for induction motor. We will see the star delta starter. So this is the diagram of star delta starter. So here stator winding is connected to the supply. So are the this is the stator winding. So it is connected to the supply, three phase supply. So in between supply and three phase induction motor stator, we have a starter. This is the stator of the induction motor. So here we have a change over switch, start to delta change over switch here. So when initially the motor is starting, the three phase induction motor stator winding is connected in star position here. So in star connection, VL is equal to root 3, line voltage is equal to root 3 into phase voltage, then line current is equal to phase current. These relations we have discussed in three phase circuits, right? So here, so phase voltage is equal to VL by root 3. So that we are, when initially stator winding is in the position of star, in the position of star connection, so phase voltage is equal to VL by root 3. So here what we are doing here, reduced voltage we are applying to the stator winding, so that the current flowing inside the stator winding is we are reducing, and torque also we are reducing, by that stator winding will not damage. So once the motor attains the rated speed, so it will convert into, the stator winding will convert into delta by using this change, this is using change over switch, right? So when starting position, so these terminals are connected to this one. So once motor starts rotate, so automatically these terminals will shift to the run position. So here we have overload relay, under voltage coil, stop button. So apart from change over switch, we have three extra devices inside the starter. So whenever load on the induction motor increases, the overload relay will send signal to the stop button here. So here stop button. So next one, whenever voltage is reduced to the induction motor, that is so supply voltage is reduced. So under voltage coil, here we have under voltage coil, that coil will send signal to the stop button. So automatically the induction motor will stop. So we are protecting the induction motor from overload and under voltages by using the coils and relays, right? So whenever person wants to stop the induction motor in between, so we can stop the induction motor. So what is the necessity of starter is here? So to protect the motor from higher currents and higher torques. So without starter, if you connect directly to the supply, so which draws more amount of current, so 5 to 7 times the rated current and 1.5 to 2.5 times the rated torque will produce, so which damage the induction motor stator winding. So to protect from damaging, so we are using the star delta starter. So when starting position, stator winding is connected in star fashion. Once motor attains the rated speed, so which automatically it changes to the delta fashion by using change over switch, that is star delta change over switch, right? So this is also one of the important question. So you have to practice this diagram and you have to explain, right? So next we'll see the problems based on induction motor. The first problem, a 12 pole 3 phase alternator which is driven by a 440 volts, 3 phase 6 pole induction motor running at a slip of 3%. Find the frequency of the EMF generated by the alternator. Right? So frequency value we have to find out. So first NS is equal to 120 F by P. Substitute the frequency and poles, will get NS is equal to 1000 RPM from the induction motor. Right? So here NS is equal to, N is equal to motor speed, N is equal to 1 minus S into NS. Substitute and motor speed is 970 RPM. So next one, as the alternator is driven by the induction motor, the alternator runs at 970 RPM. For alternator, F is equal to 12 into 970 by 120, 97 Hertz. So that is the frequency of the EMF generated by the alternator, right? So next one, a 3-phase 50 Hertz 6-pole induction motor has a full load percentage slip of 3%. Find the synchronous speed NS and the actual speed N. So these two values we have to find out. Synchronous speed formula is NS into 1, NS is equal to 120 F by P. So substitute and you will get 1000 RPM. So next one, slip you have to find out. To find the N, so we need slip. Slip is equal to NS minus N divided by N. Yes, slip already is given. So we can also find using this formula. So N is equal to NS into 1 minus S. We have a formula, right? So NS is 1000 into 1 minus slip is 3%, 0.3. So if you simplify, you will get 970 RPM. So this is one formula or one problem, right? So next we'll see one more problem related to 3-phase induction motor. A 3-phase induction motor has 6 poles and runs at 960 RPM on full load, right? It is supplied from an alternator having 4 pole and running at 1500 RPM. Calculate the full load slip and the frequency of the rotor current of the induction motor. So full load slip, S value and FR we have to find out. So we don't know the supply frequency. Supply frequency you can find out from the alternator data. Alternator data is given. So alternator is having how many poles? 4 poles and runs at 1500 RPM. From that F is equal to PN by 120. So we will get 50 Hertz. Supply frequency is 50 Hertz. So next one, what you have to find out? S. S is equal to, what is the formula? NS minus N divided by NS. right? Ns you have to find out for the induction motor. So Ns is equal to 120 F by P. Induction motor is having 6 poles. So 120 into 50 divided by 6, you will get 1000 RPM Ns. S is equal to Ns minus N divided by Ns, right? So here the induction motor is running at 960 RPM. Substitute Ns and N values, will get 4% slip, right? So FR is equal to S into F. You know the formula, rotor frequency. Frequency of the rotor current of the induction motor. FR is equal to S into F. S is equal to 4%, that is 0.04 into 50, you will get 2 Hz, right? So these are the problems based on three-phase induction motor. So please watch this videos and comment your opinion. So next we will see the more problems related to synchronous generator and induction motor next videos. Thank you.